Speaking in the National Assembly recently, Congress Maynard, Minister with Responsibility for Public Utilities, disclosed that the country is facing a national water crisis. Maynard disclosed the country is producing 5.6 million gallons of water per day from ground and surface sources, with a storage capacity of 7.5 million gallons. But he warned that demand outstrips current production.
After many years of insufficient attention being paid to our water resources, we are now facing a national water crisis. St. Kitts and Nevis is considered a water-scarce country based on the UN definition of countries with less than 100 cubic meters or 220,000 gallons per capita of renewable water resources a year. While our present production capacity is 5.6 million gallons per day, our present demand is approximately 6.6 to 7 million gallons of water per day, resulting in a deficit of up to 1.4 million gallons per day. Consequently, with a demand greater than production, the Water Services Department is unable to provide 24-hour water supply service in certain areas of St. Kitts. This, in turn, has resulted in the need for the rationing of our water supply. To compound the issue further, our projected demand for 2025, less than 3 years away, is 8.7 million gallons per day, which would represent a deficit of 3.1 million gallons a day based on present capacity to supply.
According to Maynard, improvements in the standards of living, rapid tourism infrastructure development, and increased commercial activity have led to the demand increase. He lamented, however, that over the past 7 years, very little was done to address the looming water crisis, and the aquifer is being depleted faster than it is being replenished.
The result is that we are now seeing the signs of saltwater intrusion as our freshwater levels are getting dangerously low. Additionally, as the earth continues to warm due to climate change, we see that our seawater levels are rising, which will resultantly compromise our freshwater table. Thus, I am advised to warn that if saltwater intrusion is allowed to persist because of over-extraction of our wells, our aquifers could be condemned for decades. Let me repeat that again. As we continue to take too much water out of our aquifer because we have nowhere else to get the water, it is coming dangerously close to the bottom where saltwater intrusion will happen. And salt water will come in to replace the fresh water. Because it's all connected, the sea underneath St. Kitts to the rocks, everything is connected. But salt water is heavier than fresh water, so it stays to the bottom. But if we're taking out all of our fresh water, then salt water intrusion can happen. I am advised that once that happens, our well, which was our renewable source, will be condemned for decades.
Maynard said the situation is being addressed, but the urgent need is for water conservation by residents and commercial entities. Glenn Bart reporting for SK Newsline.